Hi, welcome to my desk. My name is Ashley, and we have a new hour of work to do. I'm so glad you're here. It's Friday. It's April 30th, TGIF. It's our last day in the month of April work with me. We're going out with a bang. We're doing an hour together at the desk in real time. And if you've never been here before, welcome. I'm really happy you're joining us. You should know that this is a co-working space. I made this video for you to work along with because I am someone who misses working around people at coffee shops, at libraries. And so I started this channel in hopes of us sitting down and doing our work together. We're going to use the Pomodoro technique, which means we'll do two 25-minute work sections. That's where we listen to white noise and we focus on the task at hand. And we'll have a 5-minute break right in the middle where you can get up and refill your beverages, maybe stretch, maybe buy an Agatha Christie novel off of thriftbooks.com. Not sponsored, just something I'm going to do later in the day. I will be here, of course, chatting about a certain subject as always. And then after the break, we'll do our second 25-minute work section. And then after that, we can close our computers, go out into the world, start our weekend, knowing we already showed up, we already sat down at the desk, we already took care of business. How does that sound? Great. Well, today I'm drinking an ice water and a hot coffee with almond milk, and I'm going to be working on that essay that I've been working on the past couple of days. I'd love to know what you're going to work on and what beverages you have. Wonderful. Without further delay, let's jump into this first work section. It's going to go by so quickly. You will be shocked. Are you comfortable? I want to get comfortable. Woo! You got your workout in front of you. Is your camera focused? Okay. Are you ready to go? Shall I count us in? Here we go. 3, 2, 1, go. Ding, ding, ding. Ding, 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 ding. Wow, that's the timer. That's all right. We're about to start our last break of April together. I'm putting 5 minutes on the old clocky clock. We got a lot to cover. First and foremost, there is a fly in here and I don't know what I'm going to do. I can't get rid of it. If you see it or hear it, I'm so embarrassed. I apologize. I don't want to open the window without the screen because we're currently dealing with a wasp nest outside. So I'm more scared of wasps getting in than I care about getting the fly out. So the fly is just going to have to hang out with me for a bit, I guess, until I'm able to like open the window and then shoo him out and then close the window quickly. But I don't want to like leave the window open while I work, because then what if a wasp gets in? A wasp actually got in a couple days ago and I was chasing it all around here trying to get it out. And then it went into my air vent and we just haven't seen it since. It went straight into one of the ceiling's air vents. And so we're just like, fingers crossed, there's not like, it doesn't build a nest in there. Doesn't that sound like a nightmare? Also, I am wearing my $100,000 pyramid shirt. Nick, my guy, worked on this show. And in my mind, I was like, it's just going to look like it's laundry day. And so for the channel, I was like, in my mind, it's just going to be a cool triangle, a cool pyramid. They won't be able to read it, but you can read it. So that's what's going on with me. Also, I tried a free sample of a foundation. It is so hard to get foundation that is as light as I am. Did you see that fly? See how light I am? And then I put this foundation on and in the mirror, I was like, oh my goodness, it is going to look so dark. But you know what? It doesn't look that bad. I blended it into my neck. It's fine. I just wish that they would make it just this color, whatever. Anyway, it's a free sample. What am I doing? Am I complaining about a free sample? No. What I am doing is talking to you about the artist's way. That's right. Get your emails into me today. welcometomydesk@gmail.com. If you want to be a part of our artist way group, I'm going to be sending out an email in the next couple of days to the people who have emailed me. And we can talk about like times and when we want to start and all that good fun stuff. But I do want to explain the artist's way a little bit, because I realize that I talk about it as if everyone knows what it is. And it's just so ingrained in my mind as something that we've all either tried to do on our own or have heard people talk about. But there's a chance that like maybe you've never been exposed to it and I should just tell you what it is. And so then I went through all these articles trying to find, you know, some fun info to read to you guys, like what worked for me about the artist's way, thinking that someone would, or like, but the top five things I walked away from the artist's way, thinking I could like share that and that those people would also have described the book very well and the experience. And I found that all those articles were also working on a base assumption of their audience knowing already. So I'm taking us straight to the Wikipedia page, okay? And we're going to read that. We're going to talk about that. I mean, I'm not going to read the whole Wikipedia page because there's like a history paragraph I don't think we need to delve into, but let's just like get to the bare bones of it. What is the artist's way? Okay, that's the title, The Artist's Way, and then the subtitle is A Spiritual Path to Higher Creativity. It's a 1992 self-help book. Ooh, vintage, that's fun. 90s were cool. It's a 1992 self-help book by American author Julia Cameron. The book was written to help people with artistic creative recovery, which teaches techniques and exercises to assist people in gaining self-confidence and harnessing their creative talents and skills. Correlation and emphasis is used by the author to show a connection between artistic creativity and a spiritual connection. That's interesting. I didn't know that. I didn't know there was a spiritual element to this. I wonder how that's going to play out in our Zoom. It is a journey that we will be going on together. So the ideas in creative personal development outlined in the book, which were felt to be new at the time of the publication, are said to have become a phenomenon and spawned into many meetups and support groups throughout the world. The group meetings are based on a 12-week creativity course designed for people to work through and gain artistic inspiration. As outlined in the book, the program is focused on supporting relationships and removing artistic blocks and fostering creative confidence. Doesn't that sound great? It's a 12-week course. We're going to do it together. I've ordered my book. And I will, some of you have already emailed me saying, yes, I want to do this. Let's get this started. So I'm going to send out an email, probably not today, maybe tomorrow or Sunday. But yeah, if you're like a straggler and you're like, oh, I've been meaning to email, or I want to do this, but I didn't know if I want to do this. And man, that Wikipedia article really sold me. Then go ahead and email me. There's still space open in our group. It's going to be a wild experience. You know, I look forward to doing stuff with you guys. Okay, it's time for our second 25-minute work section. I'm rolling through today's work, and I'm going to keep riding this train right into the weekend. I would love to know what you're going to work on. Great. Well, without further delay, I will count us in. Are you ready? Are you comfortable? I am. Here we go. 3, 2, 1. Go. Ding, ding, ding on the week. Ding, ding, ding on the day. There we go. There we go. I love a fresh, crisp, uninterrupted ding, ding. I'm crossing April 30th off of the calendar. I mean, look at us. That's a full month of us sitting down at the desk, getting our work done, showing up for ourselves. You know what I like is that even if I don't have the most productive day, I still like did something, you know? Like some days when we're here, I'm like, it feels great. I'm knocking it out of the park. When our hour is done, I take a little break and then I do more, you know? And some days it's a struggle, but even on the days that it's a struggle, it's always rewarding. And I'm always glad that we were, that we met here and that we like really did our work. I'm always happy. I've never once regretted doing my work. Isn't that fun? Okay, so look into the artist's way. Email me about it if you haven't yet. welcometomydesk@gmail.com. I'm going to send out an email probably on Sunday. It depends on how much fun I have on Saturday. And then we'll get this started. I'm excited. I feel like this is going to be a really great journey. I hope you have a wonderful weekend, and I'll see you here on Monday at 10 a.m., okay? I'll see you then. Bye.